Southern girl, Shantae LeVette. And I know y'all thought that I forget. Listen, I have been getting emails, text messages, phone calls from your houses, your homes, telling on y'all about 5 more design mistakes. So let's get started. So my first message came via text message from home telling me about how she has been using all matching pieces of furniture. So, you know, you get a ticket. Who wants to come into a house that has all matching pieces of furniture? You know, the kind that you buy in the 7-piece sets, the matching coffee tables and side tables, sofa tables, everything that they had a closeout and she bought it all. Having all matching pieces of furniture can be quite boring. So mix it up. Maybe you can have a matching set of end tables and a different coffee table. You do want rhythm, but not the matchy-matchy. So I got my next message via email from home, snitching on him about using a single overhead light to light his entire space. Adding additional ambient light sets the tone and the mood for your interior space. Who wants to feel like they're being interrogated when they come over to your house for a visit? You might as well start dripping water on the top of their heads. So, you get a ticket. Go out and buy some additional lamps. They sell beautiful lamps everywhere. You can get them from Target, Home Goods. I love Home Goods because they sell them with the shades already attached. They even sell lamps at Lowe's. Or even try a secondhand store or a thrift store. So don't miss out on this opportunity to enhance your interior space by simply using lamps. So my next message came via phone from home, telling me that she is not using any reflective metals in her design. Adding reflective surfaces in chrome, brass, or rose gold would definitely up the ante in your interior space. So, you get a ticket for having a flat, monotone interior space. Mixed metals are trending this season, and I did talk about it in my interior design trends video for 2016. I think I'm going to link it right here. And this is an easy one to cure. You can just add a metallic vase to a table, or you can invest in a metallic lamp and you'll get 2 for 1. You won't have just that single light and you'll be using mixed metals in your space. And there are tons of videos on YouTube with people showing you how to change something that you already have with just a can of metallic spray paint. So if you have a piece or an object that you're not truly in love with, add a little metallic paint to it and you'll be right on trend for this season. My next message was sent to me via email from home, informing me that there has been tiny picture treachery by hanging a tiny picture on a very large wall. You get a ticket. And your home wanted me to let you know, either go big or just don't come home. Just don't come home. Matter of fact, I'm gonna give you an extra ticket for that postage size stamp picture on a large wall. I say, if you have a large wall, it is better that you just leave the wall blank until you are able to afford a large piece of art. Or, of course, y'all know my favorite, just go get you a canvas and paint your own art. But get one that's large enough for the space. Another thing that you can do if you have a large wall is to do a gallery wall. That's where you don't have to invest in just one large piece. You can accumulate pictures or objects and group them together to encompass the large space. So you got a couple of options. There is no reason for a person to hang a tiny picture on a large wall where you have to use a magnifying glass to even see it. Your homes are telling on you. And my final message for today's 5 more interior design mistakes came via text message from home to share with me the itsy bitsy teeny weeny rug that was used on her floor. You get a ticket. Yeah, you get a ticket. And everybody else is out there who has those teeny weeny tiny rugs that you can't even see past the coffee table. You get a big fat ticket. Rugs are like art for the floor. And it can be an investment piece. I would rather wait for the Mr. Perfect than to just settle for Mr. All Right. I know some of you ladies know what I'm talking about. Ideally, you do want to select a rug where the front two legs of your furniture can at least rest on the rug. And my YouTube sis Tamla over at Haute On Design has an awesome video about rug size and placement, and I'll make sure to leave the link to her video down below. I'm okay if you get a rug that's large enough to even border right up to the edge of your furniture, because rugs can get costly. So my suggestion is definitely shop discount stores. Wait till you see things on sale. Lowe's has a selection of rugs. I'm a true fan of wool rugs, and I will wait them out. I've gotten some great high-end rugs from Home Goods. I can say that they do get a selection of rugs and can be some quality rugs. And if you can, try to make sure to use a rug pad. So guys, that's it for my 5 more interior design mistakes and tips on how to fix them. And I want to sincerely thank all of the homes that reached out to me, that cried out in unison, singing this same song. This video, you can do so by showing some love and giving it a thumbs up. And of course, you can connect with me on any of my social media outlets, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I am in the process of redoing my website, so I will definitely let you all know when that process is all complete. And of course, leave your questions or comments, and I would love to hear about any more design mistakes that can be added to our list. If you're new to my channel, I would love for you to subscribe so that we can continue to have fun together. And for my YouTube family, I want to send y'all some big love from the down home south. And until the next video. Come on, make me